Hey guys, welcome back to Farming Simulator 2013 with me, BradM73. Let's see, today we're going to take a look at a couple mods. Let's see, I think of what's really changed since the last video. Not too much, I don't think. Harvested some more corn and silage and cleaned out my silage pit, so I've got a ton of money. Got 1.7, almost 1.8 million. If we look at our PDA, we've got 426, almost 427,000 wheat in storage, just under 10,000 in barley, and 571,000 in canola. So got quite a bit. Oh, and it's getting dark. We're gonna take a look at a couple mods I downloaded. And let's go to mods. Sales placeable mods brand. Mods by machine type. Okay. I don't think it was a tractor. It was a harvester. Yeah. We're going to get the New Holland elevation. Here it is. The CR9090. And we'll buy the head for that. And this one didn't come with a corn head. Not sure why. And let's see. Let's go over here to it. Oh, what's that? Hey, it's already used. Somebody got some things stuck in there. Oh, let's turn the beacon on. Oh, it's got the boring beacon. It's not like the really cool beacon. That's pretty nice looking tractor though. Let's look at the inside. Look at the carpet. I love how you can see into the fill bin back there. All right. And finally, the lights. Let's see what that looks like from the outside. There we go. Drives nice and smoothly. Ooh, cool. Look at the fans on the side. Cool. Come on. I love how speedy these things are. They should have, like, combine harvester races. Actually, they do. I seriously think they do. They have, like, in different parts of the world, they have harvesting races and, oh gosh, tractor pulls. Tractor pulls, that's a pretty old thing. I can remember going to tractor pulls when I was a kid. Not very popular in the big city, but you go out into the country, they've got tractor pulls. Now, some of the tractors from the tractor pulls are not really, like, real tractors, but you know. Come on, I got my beacons on. You got to slow down and get out of my way. Crunch. Oh, I'm not paying for it. I had the beacons on. There's our little triangular farming equipment road sign, road placard. New Holland. I don't know, for some reason that reminds me of like a loaf of bread. No change in sound from inside to out. And the lights are a little bit crazy bright. It's kind of difficult to see. But actually, that's kind of the way it would probably look in the real world. You know, if you're actually in a combine like this at night. So you're going 15 miles an hour. Hopefully I can get this guy all the way up to the top field. This harvester doesn't look very wide. I didn't even check to see how wide it was. And yeah, we could check that really quick. Hopefully. And no, we can't. Sorry. Alright, well, it's daylight out, so we can turn the lights off. I see the little rotating beacons in there. Oh gosh, this is gonna be close. Nope, that's what I was afraid of. Ooh. Let's see. I think these actually have the rotating beacons. Yeah, those are definitely the rotating beacons. But they don't have the rotating. They don't have all the lighting effects like the. The Klaus Lexion 780 mod that we had, or we have. That is a really cool mod. Let's see how our field is doing. Field number 40 should be fully grown here soon, and we will get to harvesting on that guy. I must say, he is not the fastest harvester on the farm. Come on. Now that it's daylight, we can kind of take a little bit better look. There's the radiator fans there, the cooling fans. Big diesel engine there, probably. Yep. Okay, there's our cows. So our field and our. Okay, so we can slow down time. Come on, we're almost there, and then we can go get our other mod, and we can check that out. Okay, I have no idea what the capacity of this guy is, so we'll see here shortly. Go ahead and hire him. There we go. All right. Okay. So the next mod I want to get is the still a harvester. It's the John Deere 9770ST. The reason why I wanted to get this one was because I actually found, or I, you know, had an opportunity to look at a 9660ST from John Deere last weekend, and for those of you guys that want to kind of see it a little bit up close, you can go check out the episode 2 shout out to Stocko Gloss video that that I posted this week. Oh, and that reminds me, I had some people ask why haven't I done a farming simulator video in so long, and I was having a lot of trouble getting the shout out video uploaded all week, and my internet was really slow. Hopefully I have it resolved. I've uploaded like I don't know, two or three videos, uploading a Minecraft video right now. So if you guys like Minecraft, definitely check out my Minecraft series. That's a lot of fun. But anyway, let's see here. Yeah, it took me forever, so I couldn't get that couldn't get it uploaded, and that's why I haven't done a farming video. But anyways, yeah, I saw the 9660ST, and thought, wow, that's pretty cool. So I wanted to find a 9660 mod, but I couldn't find one. So I found the 9770, which is pretty close. The mod pack includes the harvester. It also includes this guy, the Plataforma GTS do Brasil Milho, which unfortunately they don't have a picture of. But it's basically a corn head for the harvester. And it also includes the cutter, but the cutter has a little bug in it where it's not included in the harvester category, so you kind of have to go searching through all the mods to find it. It's this guy right here, missing category harvester. So the John Deere 635D, it's a very wide cutter, so we're going to go ahead and buy that too. All right. And, oh no. Well, we're just going to have to tab to it. Where are you, John Deere? Oh, brother. Well, we're going to have to run over there, I think. Oh, hold down the shift button to give us a little bit more speed. Oh, I think I missed it. Did I miss it? I didn't think I missed it. Did I buy it? I'm pretty sure I bought it. Yep, there it is. Ah, look at that. A John Deere. And here we go. And oh, wonderful. And it spawned on top of the header. Look at that. It's a John Deere. And it's dirty. This one's used too. What's going on with that? Oh, it's got the dual wheels, the care wheels, I guess. Yeah, pretty much looks like the 9660. Well, let's jump in it. Here's a jump seat. Oh, the controls. There we can see the back. Pretty cool. Alright. Well, let's try to get out of here. Uh, Oh, wonderful. Oh, there we go. All right, there we should have enough room. Come on. There we go. All right, so let's take this guy up to the field. Oh, and I want to get this guy doing course play. And let's see, this guy's going to go to the Choose Combine. He's going to be the New Holland. There we go. We're just going to have him drive the course. Where did our... Okay. Oh, turn the beacons on there. Oh, his beacons are kind of weak. But he's faster. Yeah, these beacons don't even rotate. Whoa! Oops. Watch out, truck. Wow. Okay. Actually, let's go over this way, try to cut some time off of our journey to the other side of the farm. Well, at least we got a nice fast harvester, or yeah, combine. Oh, cool, it's got another view. So when you're like this and you're like, oh, I want to jump in the cockpit, it goes to kind of more of an overhead view like this. That's pretty cool. I like that. You can't zoom in and out of this view, but I do like it. I do like this view. I do. And just for fun, I'm going to extend the boom. Yeah, look at that. That is cool. Alright, so we'll put that away. The header on this guy is really well done. Very nice and sharply detailed. Actually, I want to jump out and kind of take a look at it. It's got all the little drive shafts in here. Look at that. That looks really nice. So, yeah. Looks like our truck unloaded the barley off the New Holland. Which is good. I should have gone and looked at the New Holland to see how full it was, because I really don't know how big the load is on those. Nor do I on the John Deere. I don't know if it says. So there's tippers, harvesters. I don't think it said. Oh, here we go. 11,800 litros, or liters, I guess. Oh. And this time, instead of taking a right, we're going to go up the hill on the back side of the field to get this guy cutting. Pretty good and powerful. I'm going to give a shout out to Thomas because I know just how much he loves John Deere. And being facetious, I don't think he likes John Deere so much. I don't know why. But yeah, my uncle, he used to own a John Deere dealership, so kind of grew up around not around, but you know, John Deere is kind of always the brand to go with for us. There we go. Oh yeah, here, check this view out. Oh, cool. And he goes nice and fast. Already at 30%. See how the new Holland is doing over here. Uh-oh, there's a bug on the new Holland. If you look at the top there, you can see that the texture for the grain is not in the right place there, so that's not good. There's no, let's see. Pazigleja Transportowa. I would guess that's probably like transport mode. Oh, here we go. Maybe this will help to fix that. Okay, that looks a lot better there. Should fold out though. I'm a little disappointed that it doesn't automatically fold out into harvesting mode. Oh well. We gotta get this guy going. He is going to be field 40 to silo, and we are going to choose the John Deere. Which is this guy. Here we go. And is the John Deere filled? He is. And so we're just going to have this guy drive the course. And hopefully he will go and figure out where the John Deere is. And we'll go unload him. And there he goes, off to unload the John Deere. Now this is using course play. So it does seem like the new Holland is friendly with course play. And we'll see if this guy is. He probably will be, hopefully. There he goes. Wow, look at all that grain. Oh. Wait. So So yeah, okay, so he was 11,800. I think the Class Lexion still has him beat a little bit, but not by too much. Hey, look. Look at me in there. Oh, I like this wheat. The wheel's spinning. Ah! But the other one's not. Look at all the stuff in there that can break. Alright, there we go. Where's he going? Where are you going off to? Not sure where he's driving off to. Maybe he's just going to get out of the way. I don't know. Never seen one do that before. I guess this has tinted windows. Kind of looks like the windows are tinted a bit. Just look how dark it is there, and then look how bright it is there. Dark, bright, dark, bright. Alright, I do like this view. This is definitely cool. I feel like I'm riding up on top of it. Of course, I don't know if this would be a very safe place to be in here. Out here, truck, and get the load. Come on, he should be coming. Yeah, maybe he's gonna wait till we're full. And we're full, and he is driving in circles out there. Hey, where are you going? Heck. Oh, wonderful. Well, maybe he'll unload the New Holland now, and then he'll go over to the other tractor. Or the other combine, I mean. Oh, the problems with course play. Bonk. It's a nice, beautiful day here on Heggenstedt. Fill up! I can't jump up there. Oh well. so cool. Come on, today. Okay, here he goes. Now, get over there and unload that John Deere. You're wasting valuable time. Go. Oh, I'm like, why won't my mouse view work? Okay, yeah, it looks like he's going over there. He's bypassing the stops here. I think he might have gotten confused. And course play kind of does that. It does get confused from time to time. You probably should set, you know, especially if you got two combines working on a field with two tippers, you probably should set them manually. And what I mean by that is you actually find the combine manually and then set it to whatever combine you wanted to use. So in this case, our John Deere 9770. So maybe that will fix that problem. Let's go over here and set him up on manually. Wait until fill level is reached. Let's see here. Okay, he should be set to go. And the new Holland is halfway full. And our other driver looks like he's just going to pull out of the way here. Good job. Good job there. Guy? We don't have names for our guys. Oops. I do like the John Deere a little bit more. Maybe it's just because of it's a brand that I'm more familiar with. Oops. I haven't seen any like gigantic bugs pop out of it. And I do like this top view here. Definitely gives you a nice, gives you a nice wide view of the field. Which I really, really like. Oh, he's driving already. Where's he going off to? Now, he's not going over there to pick up that new Holland, is he? What the heck? Oh, wait. No, it looks like he's lining up with this one. Ooh, very nice. You know, that would be nice if he... Okay, so the other guy should start driving here. Yep, there he goes. Oh, yeah. Yes, unload. Oh, that's cool. So now we don't even have to stop. We can just keep on trucking. Once it reaches zero, he'll probably completely unload, or he'll probably pull off. But that's still good because it's less time that we have to spend stopped, emptying the combine. We could do it on the run. This is how they do it in the real world. At least, for big fields, I would imagine. I would think it would save tons of time. And he's gonna drive away. I'm not sure if I like the dual wheels on the John Deere's or not. Now I know that the John Deere tractors have those in real life, as you could see in the video. Okay, that's a little weird. I don't know why it makes a really wide turn like that. Let's go back to the New Holland. So he just has the two views, inside and outside. Now, I will say that New Holland is not a brand that I've heard of before until playing Farming Simulator, so I would imagine it's maybe made in Holland or somewhere in Europe. definitely has kind of that European look to it, the bright colors, the swoosh on the side. Nice tractor though, or nice not a tractor, a nice harvester. Oh, and I see a Playboy bunny sticker on it. Oh no, what is that? You guys see it right there, right above the ladder or the step ladder there? Oh man, that's maybe like a little Easter egg. I'm not sure if we were supposed to find that. Oh no. Wow. That's funny, kind of. Okay, now we are on the other side of the field, and I'm gonna see if this. Okay, he does pick up on that. Alright. Yep, he's coming over to empty the New Holland. We actually have a fair amount of this field harvested already. About halfway done. Oh, where's he going? Wait, where is he going? Well, he's on the New Holland. Huh. I don't know why he is automatically coming over here. I mean, not that I mind or anything. It definitely helps to unload the tractors on the fly. There we go. looks like the John Deere is over there unloading, I think. Oh, I think the tractor's full. Or the other tipper's full. Okay, it looks like the John Deere is continuing the harvest. And I'm sure the other tipper will come back to take... Yep, he's full. So he's going to run back to the silo and dump off all the barley. He's going to be full before long as well. And he's not filling up nearly as fast because maybe the New Holland is slightly less. And we're empty. And the John Deere is now full. So he's going to have to stop and wait for that tipper. Which is hauling butt this way. Oh, full speed. Okay. Almost looks like they should lighten up the texture on this just a little bit. A little bit darker than I would go with. And we gotta wait for our... We gotta wait for our tipper to get back. We're wasting time, and time is money. It's been a while since I can't remember the route. Did I go by the little fuel depot here to fill up our tractors when they need it? No, I guess I... Oh, yes, I did. There's that. Okay. Oh, that's good. All right, here he goes. Using course play. I'm not doing any of this. Not touching a thing right now. I got both of my hands behind my head, leaning back, relaxing. Watching course play do its thing. So it's definitely handy. Course play is definitely handy. Allows you to just do more things on the farm. Of course, we're not doing a whole lot right now, but if we were harvesting multiple fields and we had course play running on all of them, definitely makes things go much, much faster. Alright, so he's on his way back now. Let's see how our New Holland is doing. Looks like he's going to get lined up for another pass. Oops, didn't mean to jump into him. He's going to start emptying out before we can see how full we get. Oh, that's all right. does make it go a little faster. Oops. Ooh, it must be windy. Look how the barley is getting blown back. And if you keep an eye on the upper right there, we might see our other tipper come rushing up through the fields at any moment. Uh-oh, this guy's full now. Oh no! Oh, there goes our other tipper. Uh-oh, they're gonna have a traffic jam. I hope not. Hopefully he should go right to the John Deere, which he is not. He's going to drive the course. And don't have a traffic jam, guys. What's up? Oh, shoot, that was close. They're like, lol, just kidding. And then they drove away. All right, guys. Well, I'm going to wait for this guy to come in, and our time is drawing to a close because I am going to be going up to, or probably going to be going up to the real farm today to do some work. So I just wanted to do a short episode, you know, showcasing these two great mods that you can download. I'll try to get the links posted for you guys so that you can download it yourself. I would go with the John Deere, but I may have a prejudice to John Deere tractors. Sorry, Thomas. And another wonderful day on Heggenstead. If you guys have any suggestions on what mods you would like to see, please post this in the comments, or send me a direct message on YouTube. Oh, and one other thing, now you can also follow me on Facebook at BradM73Gaming. You can also follow me on Facebook. Just go to my main channel and you will see the little Facebook icon. You can click that to get to my Facebook page. Be sure to like. I'm going to be uploading and posting all of my latest videos. Also some recaps and things like that as well. So definitely follow me there too. Just helps me stay in contact with all of you guys who are dedicated fans, and I definitely appreciate the fact that you're spending your time watching. It's definitely a lot of fun for me. Hopefully it is for you too, and hopefully I can at least get a few laughs out of you guys as we play and I epically fail. So yeah, I'm gonna let these guys finish out harvesting the barley and we will come back in the next episode. Oh, one thing I did want to do before I left, I just wanted to see what all was on sale. I saw one of the brands went on sale and must be off sale already. Oh, at Etiagrar, or Etiagrar, I think it's just the front weights went on sale. All right, I wanted to check that out too before I signed off for the day. So guys, thanks again for watching. This is Farming Simulator 2013. If you have any questions or if you're thinking about buying it, you know, feel free, if you're just jumping in on this episode, you know, go back and rewatch the series. Definitely, Farming Sim is a very relaxing farming simulator that, I mean, I would not have any qualms about recommending to anybody. Definitely enjoying it myself. Really like where it's going, and you know, can't wait for future updates either. It's always cool. And maps, if you guys have a map that you want me to try out, definitely post it in the comment. I'm starting to look at maps for a potential season 2 in Farming Simulator. So yeah, that'd be a lot of fun. Alright guys, that's it for today. We got the New Holland CR9090 and the John Deere 9770, the 9770 STS. Have absolutely no idea what STS stands for. It's like the super transport system, or the, oh, I don't even know. I don't even want to speculate. But so far, definitely like the 9770. And don't forget, if you download this mod, the header is in a different category. So you're going to have to go searching through the mods to find it. So I apologize for that, but I didn't write it. So maybe they'll come out with a new version that fixes that in the future. All right, guys. I am BradM73. Once again, this is Farming Simulator 2013.